And welcome back to Houston Newsmakers. Harris County Sheriff Ed Gonzalez, Houston Police Chief Art Acevedo joining me this morning. We're talking about some of the challenges that come from crime issues in this area. National political climate is indicating that there are a lot of problems, and you've indicated that the real crime fighting has not much to do with the political rhetoric that's going on, but you need money to kind of get things going here. I had Harris County DA Kim Ogg on a couple of weeks ago, and she was talking about how much domestic violence plays into some of the biggest crimes that are going on in our area. That was surprising to me, and I guess one of the challenges is making sure other people know that that's a reality and how they can play a role in helping to reduce that.
Absolutely. It is a reality. On our homicides in unincorporated Harris County, over 40% have a linkage, a nexus to domestic violence. It's tragic. It needs to stop. It's not acceptable. It's against the law. We recently launched a gun surrender program where we're trying to tackle those individuals that where the stakes are high, situations are toxic, and we're trying to see if we can remove guns. It's still a voluntary type program, but we're working with the courts. We're working with the Houston Police Department on that as well. So we're trying to find solutions, but it definitely needs to stop in our county.
You've seen an increase in that as well in the city.
Yeah, I mean, look, when these high-profile shootings capture the public's attention, but sadly, our mothers and daughters and sisters and friends are being gunned down in domestic violence situations every day. And when we looked at last year's data, we saw a 38% increase in our city of domestic violence-related murders. So murders, 20% of the total out of the 279 were domestic violence. And so one of the things that I hope the governor will help us with this session in the legislature is how do we take guns out of the homes where women are being victimized and out of the homes where people may be in mental distress. So we can actually keep people safe.
You both are out in your communities all the time, talking to your residents, seeing what's important to them and how you can be better. The death of Jasmine Barnes certainly got a lot of the community up and active and involved. What do you hope to do to keep the communities active and involved? Because whether it's a 7-year-old or a 17-year-old or a 70-year-old, it's still somebody's life, and there should be a way to try to make sure that that doesn't happen. What kind of things can you suggest the community to do?
Yeah, well, I think, as you stated, Chief Acevedo and I believe in being very hands-on, community policing and making sure that we're out there establishing those relationships, letting the community know that they can work with us. We want their involvement. It takes a community effort to really stop crime, prevent crime, and so that's what we hope to continue to do, and also make sure that we're being aggressive in our deployment strategies, that we're tackling different issues. We're always working together very collaboratively to tackle problems together. It's hard sometimes because, you know, these crooks don't know boundaries per se, and they go in and out of different counties and different jurisdictions, so we work together. Our teams work together very well to make sure we suppress crime in our area.
City of Houston doing something unique in terms of trying to get the communities up and at them in terms of helping you?
Well, absolutely. Look, our number one force multiplier is the community itself. Sean King, who's a friend and someone I know at the national level and the sheriff knows, played a key role through social media and really spurring the community and really mobilizing the community. And what he demonstrated and what was demonstrated in this case is the power of the people will always be more powerful than the power of the crook. So when we stand up for our neighbors, when we stand up for our families, and when we stand up for strangers, we make our community safer, and that's what we need from the community. Step up, be heard, stand up, and make sure that we hold these bad people accountable.
How do you work together? When it happened in your area, what kind of communication goes to the City of Houston Police when you got a guy you're looking for? You don't even know what you're looking for at that point. You're just a blank slate trying to put together the pieces. How does that work?
Well, I mean, the chief immediately reaches out and says, hey, is there anything we can do to help? And then depending on our strategies at the time and the information that we have, we definitely work together. We work together to help develop the composite sketch, for example. Our teams are communicating if we're researching an individual that we need additional information that maybe they've dealt with, additional patrol resources to augment ours. Our task forces that already work together are part of these efforts. So it's multidisciplinary, just depends what resources needed for any given scene.
How optimistic are you that this tragic death of this 7-year-old is going to lead to positive outcomes for crime solving in our community going forward?
Well, you know, look, I believe that this community, in my heart of hearts, supports and trusts their police department, trusts their sheriff's department. And I think despite the budgetary constraints and the budgetary challenges, we're seeing some great results. This city, this county, as large as it is still a very safe community. And I think that part of my reaction to the governor is I don't want, you know, the sky is not falling. There's some tragedies that occur, but we're still seeing we're heading in the right direction. Mm-hmm. We just need some help, and we're hoping this session will get that to take it the rest of the way.
Go ahead.
And Kimberly, I want to also just commend Mayor Turner. For over a year, both Chief Acevedo and I have served on his commission against gun violence. He's coming up with a lot of different proposals that hopefully the state can, you know, follow up on as well. I know the chief's been working with national police executives as well on putting forward some proposals that will help curb gun violence in all communities. And so very positive work is being done, and by leaders like Mayor Sylvester Turner as well, that proactively had formed this a long time ago.
And we'll have to end it on that. Chief and Sheriff, thank you for coming in. We appreciate you so much.
Happy New Year.
Thank you. Yes. Yeah, and we end up on a positive note. We got a couple guys in jail for a crime. I see what happens with that going forward here. I look ahead next week to a special guest I think you'll all want to talk about, someone who is very closely associated with the University of Houston. Next.